Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel All About BI. In this video, I am going to tell you how to parse a fixed width or fixed length text file. Okay, if you have a file like a fixed length file, for example, the records might look like this. The first digit range or the first character represents the serial number. Okay, and the second character to fifth character, okay, that represents the name of a person. And then the next two characters represent the age of a person. The last five characters represent the followers in Twitter, number of followers in Twitter. Okay, so this is the format of the file. And what we have to do is we have to parse this file. We have to convert it into a CSV file, comma separated file. So after we are done with the pipeline, right? How the record should look like is 1 comma Vijay comma 40 comma 10,000. Okay, and then second Peter and 41 10,000 again, and three Bobby 38 5,000, four Shah 35 and 3,000. Why I left two characters empty here is, see, the column is fixed length column, in the sense five characters next to the serial number is dedicated for the name. Okay, so even we don't have any characters in for a particular name. For example, a name doesn't have four or five characters, right? It might have two characters or three characters. In such case, we have to leave two spaces. Okay, we'll just have to fill the five character of the column. All right, so this is how we are expecting the file to be changed after we create the pipeline and process the fixed length file. Okay, all right, how do we do it? That is what I'm going to tell you in this session. So I have uploaded the same file to my Azure Data Lake storage, and I'm going to point to this file, and I'm going to convert it using a data flow activity. Okay, so in my data flow activity, it's quite a simple task only. Okay, but we have a couple of ways to do it. I'm going to tell you the approach that is recommended by Microsoft, or the approach that is followed by the template that is present in the Microsoft library. All right. Okay, so the first task will be the source task, or the source activity, which is pointing to the text file, fixed length text file. Okay, so if you go to the source settings and open it, it will be pointing to the file 1.txt, which is nothing but our text file. Okay, and then I'm not going to give anything here apart from the name of the file. Okay, the name is given here. Apart from that, we are not creating any special thing for the data set. Okay, so coming back to the data flow. So the second field or second activity, this is what is the very important activity. This is what is going to help us achieve the task that is in our hand. Okay, so for this is nothing but a derived transformation activity. So if you click on this plus, right, you will find it under schema modifier. Okay, derived column. So this is the activity which you are going to use for converting the fixed length file to a comma separated file. Okay, but for that, what we want is, we want to know which column is of how many character long. Okay, which column is how many characters long. That is what we want to know. So for that, what we are doing is, we have added couple of parameters to the data flow. So there are two things, right? Parameter for the pipeline and parameter for the data flow. So now we are going to add four parameters for four columns that is in hand, which is nothing but the data flow parameters. Okay, so inside the data flow, if you click on anywhere outside, right, you will be able to see this parameter tab, wherein you can you will have the flexibility to add as many parameters as you want. So I have added four parameters, one for serial number, name, age and Twitter followers. Okay, and then for these parameters, right, so we'll have to hard code the number of characters that we want to parse for the particular column. For example, if you consider our input file, right, we have something called a 1,1. Okay, for example, if you look at the file, what I told you is, in this file, the first character represents my serial number. Okay, so serial number is of length one character. So from the first character, I take one character. Okay, I'll just draw numbers here so that it will be helpful. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 11. This is 12. This is 13. Okay, so all right. So now, how do we need to mention is, for the serial number column, I'm going to take from the first character and one character only. Okay, so I'm just going to take this character as serial number. And for the name column, right, what we are going to do is, we are going to start from 2. Okay, we are going to take 5 characters from the second character. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So from the second position, I'm going to take 5 characters. So that's what I'm going to mention here, 2, 5. Okay, and then after the name is done, what we have to process is age. Okay, so age comes after the name. So after 2, 5 will end up in the 7th character. Okay, so till this you have the name, and from 7th character and till 8th character you have to take for the age column. Okay, so for now what I'm going to do is 7, 8. So this is for serial number and this is for a name. This is for my age. Okay, after 7, we shouldn't be telling 8 because the second character is nothing but the number of characters that we want to extract. So in our case, age is of two character length. Okay, so we have to mention 2 here. So from 7, I'm going to take 2 characters, which is nothing but 4 and 0, 40. Okay, this is how it will take it up. Okay, so after age is done, we are going to process the next 5 characters for the Twitter followers count. Okay, so for that, what I'm doing is, so for Twitter, so after 7 and 8, from 9th character till 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, till the end, basically we are going to take it out for the Twitter count. So for now, what I'm going to tell is 9th character and take 5 characters from there. So this numbering rate, from the first character, take 1 character. From the second character, take 5 characters. From the 7th character, take 2 characters. So this is what I'm mentioning in my data flow pipeline. 1, 1, 2, 5, 7, 2, 9, 5. So this way, we will have a very neat way of handling the data flow. Okay. So after we have mentioned this, what we are going to, or how we are going to use this in the data flow, that is my second part. Okay, so till this, what I have done is, I have just pointed to my text file, which is of fixed length file, and then I have declared 4 parameters and I have mentioned the starting position and number of characters to be taken for each column. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use these parameters in the second activity, which is nothing but the derived column transformation. All right, how do I do it? So I have added 4 columns here. So if you click on plus, right, you will be able to add columns. So by that, I have added 4 columns, 1 for each column in the file. Okay, so if you look at the expression, it will be pretty simple. Since we have mentioned the starting character and number of characters in the parameter itself, data flow parameter itself, our expression is going to be quite simpler. So what we are going to do here is, so I'm taking this notepad. So what we are doing is, we are taking the serial number and then we are splitting it by comma and we are taking the first position. So basically what we are trying to do is, we are trying to take the substring of the column before we convert the input file, right? It will be in one single column only. I'll show you that in the source so that you understand it better. So everything will be looking as a single file, single column. So after we have added the transformations only, it will be split into 4 different columns. So right now the file will be looking as a single column file only. So let's see how it looks like. And if you look here, right, under column 1, we have all the text, okay. So we have to split it into multiple columns, basically 4 columns in our hand, okay. So this is what we are going to split. So basically, we will consider the whole thing as one string and we are going to take substring out of it, alright. So that is what I am doing in the expression. So take the substring from column 1. This is nothing but the default column given by the pipeline itself or ADF itself. So from this column, I'm going to take substring. So for the substring, right, we have to mention the starting position and the number of characters to be taken, right? Number of characters. So that is what we have to mention. So in our case, right, for serial number, the starting character is 1 and number of characters is also 1. So since we have already mentioned these values 1, 1, 2, 5, 7, 2 and 9, 5 and all in the data flow parameter itself or data flow default value itself, what we can do is we can split the serial number. Basically what we are doing is this is what we have in hand now. So we are going to split it by comma. So if you see here, we have given a comma. So the split will distribute the values 1, 1 into an array, basically. Okay, this will be converted to 1, 1 in an array, and after converting it into an array, I am taking the first position, so which is nothing but the 1, the character 1. Okay, so in our case, how it's going to be transformed is substring of column 1 comma 1 now. Okay, so this part is done. So we have split the serial number by comma and we have taken the first position. So we have split the serial number by based on comma and we have put it into an array and we have taken the first position, which is nothing but the 1, character number 1. Okay, and after we have taken, we are converting it to an integer because the parameter value is of type string. I'll show you that. If you have noticed, all the parameter types are string. So we have to convert it into an integer because the substring will expect integer values in the second and third parameter. Okay, so that's why I'm converting it into integer. So similarly, I'm splitting the serial number by comma and taking the second position for the number of characters. So second, the first character will be the starting position, second character will be the number of characters. So that's why I'm taking the index number 2 here. So this will give me 1. Similarly, we have to parse the other characters or other parameters also. So 1, 1 is done. For name, right, it will be 2, 5. So in this 2, 5, 2 is the first indexed element in array, 5 is the second indexed element in the array. So after we have applied the split here, right, so it will be looking like substring column 1, 2, 5. Okay, similarly for age it will become 7 and 2. This is how the expression will be changing to 9, 5. All right, so this is how we have to write expression inside the map fields, which is nothing but this is the derived column transformation, right? So I'll show you how it looks like in the expression builder. If you understand the logic, right, we are splitting the parameter, this dollar, when you see a dollar in front of the column name, right, it is nothing but the parameters. Okay, we have declared 4 parameters in the data flow, so that is accessible in the dynamic expression or visual expression builder. Okay, so we are splitting the serial number value by comma and taking the first entry or first index. This is going to be the starting position and the second parameter is going to be the number of characters. So that is how we have to understand it. Okay, so after this is done, after you write an expression, you can press on this refresh icon so that you can validate your expression whether it's going to work or not. So similarly, the same expression, but we'll just have to change the column name. Okay, for name it will become dollar name, for age it will become dollar age, for Twitter followers it will become Twitter followers. Apart from that, the expression remains the same. Okay, so right now my column was looking like one single column, everything collapsed, but after I apply the expression, right, I have got the serial number column to be perfectly coming. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we have done, we have extracted the serial number from the column 1. That is, for that only we have written the expression here. Okay, so similarly we have to do for the other columns as well. Just that, like I told you, we'll have to change the name of the column. See here, name only is changed, all other things remains the same. So similarly for third, similarly for fourth. Okay, so once we are done with this and we are looking at the data preview, we'll have the columns separated beautifully. Okay, so based on the starting position and number of characters that we have mentioned in the parameter, And this is how it is split. Okay, so if you look here, right, we don't want this column actually, so we just want these four columns, so we can remove this column. So what I did is I just clicked on this particular column and said remove. So once I did that, this activity or this step was automatically added. Okay, and finally, once we are done with everything, right, we have to write it to a CSV file. That's what is our aim is. So what I'm doing here is I'm just pointing to one location test folder in my demo container, and inside that, right, I'm going to write it as a CSV file. So I'll quickly show you. If you come to settings, right, so I'm writing it as fixed with .csv. Okay, output to a single file, so that it'll, my text file will become a CSV file and its name will be fixed with. So I'll quickly run this pipeline. It's all based on the starting character and number of characters, and one, if you make any mistakes, they write, then it will collapse the whole processing, so you will not get the expected output. So just while you design the pipeline, just be cautious to handle it properly. All right, so I had already run it and show you how it looks like. After the pipeline is run, I'll get a CSV file with the same data but comma separated data. See here. And one of my subscribers and viewers have asked whether we can process two different files of different structures using the same or using one data flow activity. Okay, so I tried doing it, but I could not finish it off. So if you have any ideas related to that, you please let us know so that I can work on it and post it for you. Alright, thanks a lot for watching. Keep supporting. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to All About BA. Thanks a lot.